How are you?
Hi, good, how are you?
Great. Are you folks coming separately?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep, they'll be arriving soon.
When we first started with her in basketball back when she was in second grade, we just thought, you know, I think she's going to probably be pretty tall and going to have a good time doing this and maybe get to play after high school at some point. So this is beyond our wildest dreams. We brought her, you know, to all the AAU games and, you know, practices. And I was able to coach her for 1 year in high school, which was a lot of fun, her sophomore year when her sister was a senior. And we went to the state tournament in Wisconsin, and that was a lot of fun. That was a special time. I got to spend, you know, practice with them after school every day, and that was pretty amazing. But just, you know, we logged a lot of miles and went to a lot of places, and it's been a great ride. Just hoping that she ends up with a team where she's going to be a good fit, and that she's going to have some great teammates and great coaches and have a successful career. That's what I'm hoping. Just her passion and her persistence and her effort in absolutely everything she does, I think that will carry over into the WNBA.
Graduated from a class of 11 kids. I mean, who would have thought that I'd be here in New York?
Yes, of course.
What's this whole experience been like in New York for you? I know you've got a lot of events going on, but what's it been like?
It's been incredible just to learn about the WNBA and what it's all about, what it represents. And, you know, I'm so excited to be with some strong, powerful women here in the future.
You're excited? Just kind of tell me what these next couple hours are going to be like for you. Nervous at all or anything?
Yeah, a little bit of nerves, but honestly, mostly excitement. I'm so excited to see what the new adventure holds.
Hey, Coach.
How you doing?
How you doing?
This right here.
Hey, Megan's mom. How you doing? Megan's dad?
Yep.
How you doing? And Megan's sister?
Special event for Megan, and just real excited for her. We don't know what's going to happen, but we're excited, and hopefully things will go really well for her. We're just sad that her career in Iowa has come to an end. It's been fun watching her. We never expected that. I mean, this whole, it still hasn't really hit me. Maybe it will someday, but just just never expected that she would play at such a high level and do so well. I don't know what else to say. I'm still in shock. It'd be nice if she could play closer to home.
Okay.
From northern Wisconsin. But, you know, really, anywhere she goes, we're just going to be thankful that she has the opportunity. And I think that's how she feels as well. So she'll be ready. She was fairly young. She talked about playing professional basketball. So I think this is in the back of her mind that this is what she really wants to do early on. And her dreams are coming true. So I'm excited to see what the next chapter brings. Yeah, we did a lot of travel. It's 8 hours away to attend her home games. So
how long was the trip?
8 hours one way.
Get out of here.
Yeah, no, that's how far it was. So we couldn't make it to all the games, but okay, we made to quite a few of the home games. Yeah. But my two sisters and I were a threesome. We call ourselves the Triperfectas. And we've been going to a lot of the games and rooting them on. Just having a lot of fun.
It's so exciting, right? You bring these players in out of high school, and this is the dream. This is what everybody is going for, and so we're excited to be able to share with Megan tonight.
What are some of the things that are going through your head?
Well, you know, it's really, like I told her, it's out of our control right now. Let's not worry about where you're going. Everything's going to be good. Whatever happens tonight is good.
It's an amazing experience to be here and see her develop as a young kid into an adult. Playing the WNBA, I'm excited for her. The last few weeks have been a blur. Going to Tampa Bay, seeing her get all of her awards, it's just been a wonderful experience.
When you guys were young, did you guys play one-on-one, or do you still play one-on-one?
We did in high school a little bit. We kind of were a little bit competitive, then I finally realized she was going to be way better than me, and I just kind of gave up, and I just learned how to pass her the ball.
There's some nerves, because if you think about it, you get to decide where you go to high school, and you get a chance to decide where you go to college, and you get to decide what happens in a game, how you perform, and now for the first time in your life, you don't get to decide. Someone's deciding for you.
Good evening, and welcome to the 2019 WNBA Draft. We're embracing and celebrating what makes this league and the women of the WNBA so exceptional. Their power and confidence, their ability to inspire, and their determination to challenge convention on the court and in our culture. It's basketball on their terms, with players at the heart of it. To each of you here in New York and watching at home, waiting to hear your name called, to your family and friends who helped get you here, congratulations. Enjoy this moment and welcome to the WNBA.
With the first pick in the 2019 WNBA Draft, the Las Vegas Aces select Jackie Young from the University of Notre Dame. Select Sophie Cunningham from the University of Missouri. The Atlanta Dream. the draft rights to Breonna Turner to the Phoenix Mercury for Marie Gulich. And with the 17th pick in the 2019 WNBA Draft, the Dallas Wings select Megan Gustafson.
Megan Gustafson was widely considered to be the best women's college basketball player this past 2018-19 season. Gustafson was the recipient of the very prestigious Naismith Trophy as the Player of the Year in women's college basketball. The trophy is named after the inventor of the game of basketball, Dr. James Naismith. Megan was the Associated Press Women's College Basketball Player of the Year and ESPNW's National Player of the Year. In the 2018-19 season, Gustafson became just the fourth Division I female student-athlete to eclipse 1,000 points in a single season. Megan holds the Big Ten Conference records for most points and most rebounds in a single season. Dallas Wings President and CEO Greg Bitt had this to say. To get a player of Megan Gustafson's talent at number 17 is a steal. You're talking about a player who led Division I women's basketball in scoring and field goal percentage this season. She has great hands, plays angles well, and is a fierce competitor. I think she's going to come into camp and show well. I am beyond thrilled that she was available to us at number 17.
Coming in, and I'm just excited to see what I can do. I'm just going to work hard as hard as I possibly can. I just have to thank the University of Iowa for an amazing ride. They've pushed me to be the best player I can be, and I'm just very excited to keep it going.
Okay. So, Coach Marsh, straight to camera. You're just going to say your name, your new team, and then I'm playing Name That Play.
Dallas Wings, and I'm going to play Name That Play.
Awesome. I'm going to take you back memory lane of drafts past. I'm going to show you some photos.